Hello everyone, I'm David Moffat from Axe Annex Tabletop Gaming, and today I'm going to show you how to paint teeny tiny little soldiers. Okay, I have some GHQ infantry here. I think the Vietnam era US troops, the regular infantry, also have some heavy weapons. The site seems to be down right now, though. I can't access it on any of my devices, so I couldn't double-check the name, but yeah, I'm pretty sure they're the GHQ Infantry. I've primed them with an almond satin finish. I'm going to take some Agoros Dunes contrast, and I'm going to apply it to all the little dudes. I'm just going to take the Agoros Dunes and I'm going to slather it on. More worried about putting it on the uniform than I am about putting it on flesh or the guns. Now they have a tiny bit of definition. This will help us pick out the details. These little pouches. Straps. Little helmets, of course, and their guns. This guy has a rifle or a shotgun. That's cool. Well, let the contrast dry. I'm going to go ahead and do up all the heavy weapons dudes. Right. Looks like the contrast is pretty dry. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take some of this Terminus Stone dry paint. A bit of tender dry brush. GHQ especially, some pretty thin angles. So I want to make sure not to dry brush them too hard and tear them right off. And sad about that. Alright, starting to get some definition now. Now I'm going to take these dudes and put a little flesh color on them. I'm going to use the dark with flesh. Yes. Alright. Here, have a flesh tone. Let's move on to the heavy weapons teams. Alright, Dark Oath Flesh applied. Next, I'm going to take some of this Black Templar and I'm going to put it on their guns. Get this arm? Looks like it. That happens sometimes. Just randomly forget. Somebody looks very obvious when you start painting. So I'll just fix it right now. This little guy has a knife. Yet. Zuka. There we go. They're popping now. Guy. Forgot to give this guy a bit of color on his binoculars. Pop that. There we go. Then last I'm going to come back in with Agoros Dunes. Color a few spots. Boots. And also the ammo bits here. That should be good. Boots are darker. Some more on my palette. Was there something I was going to touch up? I don't know. Everybody's looking alright. Next, I'll lay down my gesso. Soak into the MDF. To prepare it for the next step, which is the extra. Thank you. All right, texture paint applied. Take a little while to dry. A couple areas to touch up. This gun has a bit of metal here to keep it from the barrel just collapsing on itself. I cut one off once and certainly did collapse. I don't put a wash on the base, especially with these guys, because we can't remove their little tiny bases. If you put it on a wash, it really accentuates the squares that are on their feet. I'll need some brassy color. Do a bright bronze. I could do a tinny tin. I think I'll do a tinny tin because I don't want to make it too bright on the shells. Next, I'll take some of this Abaddon Black and I'm gonna do the final lap on the bases. Oh, yeah, I was gonna touch up that spot. I'll do that right now. Since I've already forgotten once. Next up, I'll take some of my Woodland Scenics foliage. Start adding some bushes. Alright, bushes, bushes, bushes. A little of my Gorilla PBA glue. Alright, let's see how that looks. Dab it down into the glue. Going through the bushes. Add one more bush right here. That's pretty fun. I'm in the bushes. In the bush, gunning people down. All right, exciting times. Lastly, take some of my ground covering here. Dab it around. I don't have to cover the whole ground. Just some. likely have a little bit of spaces for air dirt. This is Badlands. Everybody's fighting in the Badlands for me. Badlands obsessed. When we pour this on top, it'll stick, and it'll also get caught up in the clump foliage, which adds a bit of color there too. It's not just a solid green. And every once in a while you get like a little rock stuck, and that's perfect. That's it, we did it! I'll put up some pictures at the end of this video, because my camera can take pictures of the 6mm infantry slightly better than this video camera can. Yeah, they look pretty great. Definitely gonna add a lot of flavor to the tabletop. Alright everyone, thanks for watching, bye bye!